माता जी। गुड
आफ्टरनून एस सफा, हैव यू फिनिश्ड योर लंच?
यस
सुशांत, हैव यू फिनिश्ड योर लंच?
यस माता जी।
ओके, सो मॉर्निंग I have put this one, no, yeah, what question and answers of Vijayanagara. Yes, yesterday we have learnt about the Vijayanagara lesson, yes or not? Only 9 members they have. Yes. Good afternoon, Pratyusha.
Good afternoon, Mataji.
Good afternoon, good afternoon. Only 10 members. Good afternoon.
Good afternoon, Madhaji.
Good afternoon. Yes, yesterday's regarding yesterday's lesson, do you have any doubt? Vijayanagara kingdom?
No, Madhaji.
No. Okay. Have you written today what I have sent? Do you have written? Yes? No? Nobody has written? I sent you some question and answers of your Vijayanagara dynasty and map work I have given. Yes or not? Any doubt in that?
No, Mataji.
No. Okay. So, what else are there? Anything? Regarding you are having doubt or you are fear not regarding any doubt?
Mataji, discuss the following Varsidra.
Discuss following, discussing following Varsidinala, Hakidinala.
Mataji, Ali, Varaklila, first one or second one early?
Second question on the Hakidinala. Up to discuss first answer, I have sent you question with answers. So, then again, question number second, discuss answer only I have sent. Regarding literary or the literary contributions. Yes or not? Make a list of literary contributions. Right? It is there, children. Once again, you go through that. Okay, the last page what I have sent. No, that is the second answer, second question answers of your discussed answer of first lesson, Vijayanagara dynasty. Yes? Only 14 members, 13 members, again somebody went. Nanage illi attendance gottagutte nimdo.
Good evening, Mataji. Good afternoon, Mataji.
Yes. Any doubt, children? I'm waiting for others, children. Only 14 members are there, so that I'm waiting. Yes. Shall we start?
Okay, Mataji.
Okay, Mataji.
After Vijayanagara kingdom, now today one more lesson we are going to learn, that is constitution. What is that? Constitution, especially Indian constitution, our constitution we are going to learn. What is that? Our constitution means what? Indian constitution about we are going to learn. Understood? Can you see the board, children?
Yes, Mataji.
Board alli kanustidya?
Mataji.
Nan yen bardidini kanustidya?
Yes, Mataji.
Yes, Mataji.
Okay, okay. What is the meaning of constitution? First tell me. Regarding constitution, so many times we have discussed in the school and morning time you are all singing that prayer, isn't it or not? Morning in the school morning, you are singing the preamble, yes or not? Daily you used to sing preamble. What is that preamble, children? We the people of India having solemnly resolved to, yes or not? India into sovereign, socialist and secular, democratic republic and secure to all its citizens. Yes or not? What is the meaning of citizenship? Last year you have learnt about the citizenship, right? So what is the meaning of citizenship? Anyone? Sushant, Amrita, what is the meaning of citizenship? Nobody. Yes, Sushant. Tell me the answer. Gautami, tell me the answer.
Mataji, can Siddhi? I tell? Can I tell?
Yes, Vasudhara, tell me.
The position or states of being a citizen of particular country.
Very is good, very citizenship. Good. Yes, that is called citizenship. Alva, why we need a citizenship, children? Is it necessary?
Yes.
Yes. Why it is necessary? Citizenship, why it is necessary, children? It is the right of our, isn't it or not? We are the citizen of India. It is our individual rights. Yes or not? So that is what our government has done. We are all born here. So from the born, we are all citizens. Understood? Citizen of India. Understood? Wherever, whichever the country we can go. But if we are born in India and we were settled in India, then it is called citizenship. And then now, you know, India citizens. Understood? That rights, individual rights, our government has given children. Got it? So these citizenships, somewhere there were conflicts regarding our religion or locality or society. In our society, we are having the lots of problems are there. Yes or not? There may be conflicts between the two religions, two or more religions regarding. Or else, if there were no police officers or no government officers, or there is no rules and regulations for the country, then what will happen? What will happen? If there is no rules for the country, then we cannot live satisfactory. Yes or not? Why? Because always somewhere crime is going on, or murder is going on, robbery is going on. Yes or not? Or else on the road, what will happen if there is no traffic police? There were an accident. It may happen. Yes or not? For that reason, we need rules and regulation. These are all the rules and regulations government, it has given to us. That is also one of the rights of the citizens, okay? And by birth only we are having the rights. What type of the birth? Birth means, birth only we are having the rights means, what is that? Birth only we are having the rights. That is called natural rights. Yes or not? For example, right to education, right to equality, right to freedom. We are talking each other freely. Yes or not? No hesitation. If I want to talk with anybody, then without hesitations I can talk. But whatever the speaking, whatever I am speaking, it should be in manner. Yes, it is depends upon our manner and the behavior. So that citizenship or the that country, it has given the some rights for the citizens of India. Okay, but who was given? Do you know that? Who was given? Constitution is says government has given. Yes, correct. But government for rules and regulations, who were created? Who was this written by Dr. B.R. Ambedkar? Understood? It is made by Dr. B.R. Ambedkar. So he was called Samvidhana Shilpi. What is that? Means constitution. He was written the constitution, children. Got it? Then another thing is, so many people, they were trying to bring the equality among the people, because after 1947, means before that, during the time of before 1947, it was ruled by so many kingdom, or the monarchical rule was there. Then British people, they were ruled us, yes or not? But during the British time, what happened? They were if their person means their country people, they were given the most opportunity. It may be job facilities or the promotion, whatever, salary. These are all the British people, they were given to the British people only. Okay, those who are the British authorities or the British officers, for them only they have given. So in India, there were no rights. If we are asking to British people, then they were started to torturing us. For example, do you know that rights, if they are asking, what are the rights? Yaar yaar irbodu namge Sangolli Rayanna, isn't it? Then Kittur Rani Chennamma, isn't it? So these are all the people, they were dedicated to themselves because of bringing the independent India, isn't it? Means a free India. And what do you call that? This constitution is very, very important. Why? Because Dr. B.R. Ambedkar and so many members in this, one of the person called Rajendra Prasad, Babu Rajendra Prasad, he was a first president, understood? He was a first president. Then first president of India also, as well as the Constituent Assembly also. During the time of 1946, 9th December, they were held the first session of Constituent Assembly. So in that Constituent Assembly, they were discussed about the rules and regulation and the laws of the country. Understood? It was made up of Dr. B.R. Ambedkar. He was created that. What are the rules and regulation? It will apply for the citizens as well as the country. Like so many articles, amendments and schedules, parts, like that he was written. Understood? So 2 years, 11 months he has taken to read the constitution. So now tell me, what is a constitution? It is a set of basic rules, or it is given to the citizen of India, or to follow the, for example, government should follow the rules and regulation first, yes or not? Then what they will make us law, then we are all following. Got it, children? So your constitution means it is a set of basic rules, and it was written, children. It has written. It is the lengthiest written document all over the world. Andre idi world alli, what is that? Whole world, it is the lengthiest written document. And it is compared to the Britain constitution also. What is that? Britain constitution. Okay. So it is a set of basic rules followed by country. Whatever the constitution they have been given for us, so we are all following the constitution. Understood? Means for us only they have made the constitution. And it will apply for the all three organs of the government. What are the organs of the government? Legislature, judiciary, then executive. Isn't it? So all three it was applied. It is a set of basic rules. Rules and the regulation. Understood, children? So, and what else? For example, we are all having some basic rights or the natural rights. Okay. Basically, or by birth only, we are having the natural rights, children. Instead of that, it has given to us some fundamental rights. What is that? Fundamental rights. What are those? What are the fundamental rights? Do you know that one is right to equality, right to education, and right to religion? Okay. Right to equality means what is that? Here, it may be VIP person, president, or the prime minister, or the parliamentarians. Parliamentarians means executive bodies, okay? Governor, prime minister, president, who are the Lok Sabha or the Rajya Sabha members, okay? That much you have learned in the last year, yes or not? Government lesson I told you. What are the government organs? Legislature, executives, and the judiciary, isn't it? If anybody, they were exploited by the others, then they will get a punishment. If anybody, they were harms our rights, okay, our individual rights, if anybody they will exploit, then they'll get a punishment according to the judiciary, isn't it? So in this judiciary, it is an independent judiciary. No one is interfering in this matter. Maybe executives, prime minister, president, or whoever, okay? So nobody interfere in this judiciary, isn't it? So that much constitution, it will say the organs are so, three organs of the government, whatever it is there, no? So for them also, it will give the guidance, one thing. Secondly, right to equality is a fundamental, because six fundamental rights and 11 fundamental duties, these constitution will say, got it? So this constitution, first of all, fundamental rights I can take, okay? One is the right to equality. Right to equality means here, there is no differences or the discrimination among the religion or any caste or creed or languages, whatever. Got it? So it should be equal to all. It may be beggar or it may be VIP person or a ministers. So all citizen of our country. So everybody, it is equal. Understood? Then secondly, right to education. What is that? Right to education. What is the meaning of right to education? We are all having the birth right to get an education. Yes or not? Yes. Education means if there is no education, then everybody they'll see how they'll see. Ayya, avuna, avunike yen vidyavantam alla, avunike yenu barala, avunike yenu gothagala. Like that they are creating, isn't it or not? Yes. So education is very, very, very important, children, to know about our duties and rights. Then to know about our world, country, or any information we can get it, yes or not? So education, and wherever we need to go, for example, if it is court or if it is any office or higher job, or if you are going to foreign to get the job, then you need an education, yes or not? So education is very, very important, children. Understood? You want the sign hakbek andre namge education beku, adilla andre thumb hakbek andreva, we have to put the thumb sign, yes or not? But if we are educated, then we can take a pen and we can sign it, any document. It may be property or it may be any official documents, yes or not? So that is called the right to education. Here education also, in the classroom, everybody is sitting together. There is no discrimination among the people. Yes or not? No caste differences or no girls, boys like that, or no caste, whatever. So, or whoever they came to any religion base. So, everybody here, equally they are sitting and equally they are getting the education. That is called right to education. And the government will say that from 6 to 14 ages, we must get the basic or the elementary education, children. What is that? Basic or elementary education, we must from the 6 years to 14 years. Understood? So, another thing is right to religion. Here, Bhauddhas, Sikhs, Muslims, Hindu, Christian, Parsi, Jaina, Vaishnava, so many religions are there in India. But every religion, it is equal in front of the constitution. Understood? That is what means they can come to any religion, caste or creed. Okay. But in front of the law, it is equal. Understood? It is equal to all. They can go to any temple, they can worship any god, or they can go to church, they can go to mosque, or they can go to temple, or anywhere they can go, any worship of God or any religion they can, understood, they can follow. So nobody is asking, even court also it is not asking. So that is the right of the citizen. Then another thing is right against exploitations. If anybody they are harming us or exploiting us, exploiting andre namge yaradru bandu society nalli athwa locality nalli yaradru namanna torture madidre, that's called exploitation. Understood? So that exploitation, if it has happened, then we can approach the court. So there is a judiciary, no? So the court we can approach. So nobody should harm anybody. Understood? Nobody should torture or exploiting others. Okay, but before the 1940s, when it was there in the country, there was a woman condition was not good, child condition was not good, like that. Okay, I think in your age, so many people they were working in the what you call that, garage, factories, like that. Okay, hotels, like that. But the government, it will says that right to education for them. So means government is giving nowadays a free education as well as the midday meals and lots of things. What is that, the stationery item? Everything is freely they are giving. Yes or not? So why they are giving? Because everybody must get the education. Understood? So here there is no discrimination among the religion. And nobody should exploit to us. If they are exploiting, then we can approach the court. Then somewhere cultural rights and the other aspects are there. That will go for next lesson and we will learn. Because fundamental rights and duties, again you are having the lesson, children. Got it? As a citizen of India, what we are having the rights, like that we should follow some rules and regulation also. Means there is a fundamental duties. As a citizen of India, what we have to do, we should respect our elders, our legends, and our historical places we have to protect, environment we have to protect it, then national symbols or what you call it, national flag, national emblem, and national anthem, we need to give our respect. Yes or not? That is our that's our rights and the duties. Okay, so these are six fundamental basic. Okay, fundamental rights and the duties of the citizens who has given, constitution is given. Understood? This constitution means what is that now? Tell me. It is a set of basic rules to apply in our country. It is the lengthiest written document. Got it, children? And it will give the guidance to the three organs of the government, by legislature, executive and the judiciary. Got it? Then that three organs, they were assisting us. Assisting us means they are giving the guidance to us. Yes or not? And these constitution, it is applying state as well as the central level. It is only one. Okay, so that it is very biggest and lengthiest. It is applying same for country as well as the state. Here there is a not separate for Karnataka or Indian government, like that. All the government, all the states and the, what you call that, central level, at the central level and the state level, it should apply. So that it is called very lengthiest constitution. Then another thing is, what is the importance? First, we have to learn the importance of our constitution, isn't it or not? It protects the citizens' right. I already said that, yes or not? Always, constitutional law will say that, what is that? It protects the rights of the citizen of India. And it functions the guidance duties of the citizens. Whatever the duties we have to do in as a citizen of India, which are the duties we have to do, and if we are we are the person of government, for example, Pritika, she is a police officer, then she needs to take some guidance of the government, yes or not? Then she is following, and like that Pritika, everybody is following, isn't it? So like that, we are having the guidance also. Then we coordinate the functions and democratic institutions. You know what is the meaning of democratic? Last year you have learnt about the democratic and republic government. What is the meaning of? Kalthidiralva, dictatorial rule, communist rule, and democratic rule. What is the meaning of democratic rule? Means it means India, it is a democratic and republic country. Why? Because here the people, they are having the election system here. In that election representative, they are chosen by the people. Yes or not? Here, democracy system is there. People, by the people, of the people, and for the people. Like that, we are having the democratic system. Understood? So that India is a republic country. Every 5 years once, election is going on. Then that election, particular leader, best leader, we are going to choose through giving a putting a what do you call that, the votes, okay, isn't it? So like that, votes if we are giving, then only they come up, so not then they form, like that person, they are forming the government. That government executives are there, prime minister and governor and state chief minister, then financial minister, defense minister, railway ministers, education minister, so many ministers. Yes or not? There's branches. So many types of the governments are there. That governments, they are having the separate departments. Okay. So that departments, they are allocating the functions and it coordinates between the states and the central government. That is the duty. And another thing is, it organizes better relationship between the state and the central government. There is no separate rules for the central government or the state. Okay, it is equal. It is the same. It will apply. Whatever the law they are making, that law, it will apply same for the country as well as the state. Okay, then this is called importance of the constitution. Okay, then I already said that. What is that? How they were created, who are the persons involved? So many persons involved. Why? Because of the torture of the British people at the end of the 1946 and 47 children. So many people, they were involved to make a constitution. They need a freedom from the British people. Include Subhas Chandra Bose, Motilal Nehru, Jawaharlal Nehru, Dr. B.R. Ambedkar, Gandhiji. so many people, isn't it? So many freedom fighters also, they wanted to make a separate constitution. Why? Because this constitution, it is based on British people only, children. So that we are all following the Britain constitution only. Understood? They brought the Regulating Act and the Pitts India Act, like that acts they were brought. But in the 1935, they brought the Indian Government Act. So this was given to the India little satisfaction, but not fully. So that our Subhas Chandra Bose as well as the Jawaharlal Nehru and Ambedkar, they were started to creating the new rules and regulations for our country. Okay. But during the time of 1946, the 9th December, they were held the first session or the first meeting of the Constituent Assembly. In that Constituent Assembly, President was Babu Rajendra Prasad. What is that? Babu Rajendra Prasad. Okay. During the time, there was a 299 members were there. Yes, to know, bari 3-4 jana alla. How much it is? 299 members, they were in this Constituent Assembly session meeting. Okay, means they were discussed regarding our country, about the laws or the rules, rights, etc. Then there is a so many amendments was there while they were written during the time of 1946 or the 47, there was a 2473 amendments, constitutional amendments. And what the rules they have given, so what the law they made, that law somewhere there is a correction. Tiddupadi. What is that? Tiddupadi. That is called amendments. Okay. But now present it is 98 amendments. See. How much it is? It was 2473 amendments. Now they were corrected that law. It is approved by the Rajya Sabha, Lok Sabha members as well as the court. Okay. Then with the opinion of the public, then only they can, majority of the people, they need to take the advice, children. So majority of the people means, out of 100, there must be a 75 to 80 members' permission. Got it? Then only means their acceptance they need. That is called majority. Okay, so majority acceptance they have to take. In that 2473 amendments, now present there is only 98 amendments are there in our constitution. I already said that it is a bill. Then during the time 448 articles were there, but now it is 395. How much? 395 articles. Then there were 8 schedules, but before that it was 12 schedules. Now it is 8 schedules. Before that it was a 25 parts, but now it is 22 parts. Okay, how much it is? 395 articles, 12 schedules and 22 parts. But now 98 amendments, 22 parts, 8 schedules and 395 articles. Now let's stick to 440. Okay. So they are amending with the approval of Rajya Sabha and Lok Sabha members. You know about the Rajya Sabha, Lok Sabha members. It is a two structures. Why? Because our it may be Karnataka or our central government, it's a bicameral legislature. Yes or not? Two legislatures were there. One is Rajya Sabha, another one is Lok Sabha. Okay. So that person, they have to give a acceptance. Understood? Then only they can amend the constitution. Hage sum sumne adanna correction maada kagalila. Andre avrige bekadage maadkolakagalla. Okay. So that was the constitution, it will says, or it is having, so that I told that 2 years and 11 months it has taken to return. Understood? Then at the time of 1947, Ambedkar, he was a lawyer. Okay, he was a lawyer. During the time of 1950 and 51, in India, first time the election was held. In that election, it is a general elections, okay? So in that general elections, people were elected by the people only. Understood? That who are the representatives? That representatives, they were elected by the people of India. What is that? People of India. During the time of 1950 and 51, they were held the election. In that, Babu Rajendra Prasad become a president first president. Okay. Then Prime Minister Jawaharlal Nehru. Then in this constitution, there is a it was written by the Ambedkar, isn't it? So this Ambedkar became a drafting committee chairman. Understood? Drafting committee means Karudu Samiti and Kannada. Okay, means whatever he was made the rules that it is in the book. Okay, that book he was written. Okay, so that they were chosen as a drafting committee chairman. Understood? During the time of 1950, this constitution was accepted, but it was taken the approval 1946 November 26. So that every year, almost 11 years. What is that? November 26th, we are celebrating the Constitutional Day. Yes or not? In our school also, we are all celebrating. What is that? Indian Constitutional Day, November 26th. Why? Because November 26th, 1949, it got the approval of the Constituent Assembly. Then, during the time of 1950, January 26th, it is accepted by the Indian government. Is it clear? So that during that time, on the 1950, January 26th, one thing it is accepted by the government. Yakandre, another thing is, during the time of 1935, during the time of 1935, the British rule was there. No? So during that time, January 26th in India, under the leadership of Subhash Chandra Bose and Jawaharlal Nehru, they were spread the news, India got a freedom. Understood? Means, Purna Swarajya, anta ghoshane maartare avaru. So on that day only, Constitution also accepted by the Indian government. So on that day only we are celebrating Republic Day. Understood? January 26th only we are celebrating the Republic Day. Why? Because there was a lots of stories, dedication of our legends. That story was there. Understood? So that on that day only Constitution accepted by the government as well as Republic. Now January 26th anta celebration martivi alva, Republic Day we are celebrating, no, because of that reason only. 1935 January 26th they made the Purna Swarajya. Understood? So Purna Swarajya ghoshane martara alva, so adhe disa yen martare, 1950 January 26th constitution also accepted by the government. Okay, so another thing is, this constitution, it will tells the preamble of the constitution. Means in that book, constitution book, in the first preface anta kodtaru, so first page they have given about the preamble. What is that preamble? What is that preamble, children? This is, yes, the in the school morning prayer we are all singing this. We the citizen of India, having solemnly resolved to India into a sovereign, socialist, secular, democratic and republic. Why we are all saying these are all the things? Why? Because I already said that. What is that? It is the sovereign. Sovereign means what? Sarvabhaumatva. Means everybody, they are all equal and they are equally, they are giving the votes. Yes or not? And it is a people rule. It is a democratic means what is that? It's a people rule. Understood? Then another public rule. Then secular, dharmikavadattu. Secular means here there is no discrimination among the religion. So that it is called secular country. And another thing is, it is a socialist. What is that? Socialist. Then another thing is justice, liberty, equality, fraternity. Justice means for everybody. What is that? Justice means for everyone. Here there is no discrimination among the caste, creed, higher person or VIP person like that. So everybody, they are having the same equal justice. In front of the justice, everybody, they are equal. Understood? Then the liberty. For example, speaking the speech. Yes? Speaking rights or talking to any person, that liberty we are having. Then we can move apart from the country or inside the country very freely. So not wherever we can settle in our country. So nobody is asking. For example, if I want to go to Bangalore, I can settle there. Yes, I can. So nobody is asking us. So that is called the liberty. Then equality. I always said that equal to, in front of the law, everybody, they are all equal. There is no discrimination among the caste, creed, language, religion, nor whatever, female or gender, whatever. Okay. Then the last one is fraternity. Fraternity is assuring the dignity of, for example, I am a teacher or anybody, they are a doctor. So their dignity, it is maintaining, it is protecting our dignity. Understood? So that they have given a equality, fraternity, liberty, and another thing is fraternity, it is assuring the dignity of the individual and unity and integrity of the nation. So those who are all living in this country, as a citizen, we need, these are all the things. So not, so our preamble, it will say, means this constitution or the Ambedkar, what he was saying, preamble means it is a socialist, it is a secular, it is a democratic republic, and it is a sovereign state, it is giving to us justice, liberty, equality, fraternity. Understood? All the political life, economical life, and the social life, everything we are getting equal opportunity, maybe in the job facilities or it may be in the school or wherever we go. So everywhere there is a equality we have to maintain. Understood? That is the government is giving to us. Then there is so many features are there. Then next we'll continue in the next classes, children. Understood? What are the features are there in the constitution? Regarding, we learn more about next class. So now, anybody, do you have doubt?
No, Mataji.
No, Mataji.
Did you understand?
Yes, Mataji. Yes.
Mataji.
Huh?
Mataji, can you repeat the question?
When the constitution accepted in India?
1949.
1950, not 49. 49 it was approved by the government, accepted by January 26.
Yes, Mr. J.
Next, what is the proof of constitution? Bharati?
A set of basic rules followed by the people of India.
Yes, very good. Then, it is a set of basic rules followed by the country. Then, what else? What our preambles will say? Preambles, what it will say? Adhya is here. Pratyusha. Kirti. Yeah, Pratyusha, tell me. Sumai. Pranav, Egde. Yes, anybody, can you tell me the class first? Okay, you are having next class, right?
Yes, Mataji.
Tell me about that. What our preamble? Preamble, it is said in the heart of the what it will say? India, it is a sovereign, socialist, secular, democratic and republic country. Then it will give you liberty, justice, equality, fraternity and fraternity. The dignity of the individual. Yes or not? Yes? Who was the first Prime Minister and first President of this Constituent Assembly?
Babu Rajendra Prasad was the first President And Jawaharlal Nehru was the first prime minister.
Who was the drafting
Mataji, baki avrige mute madkolli kelri nimdu sari kelta illa.
Please switch everybody mute on your mic children. I'll ask the question to okay nane kelthini nanige nim number bartide Safa who was the drafting chairman committee member Amrita Kushi
Dr. B. R. Ambedkar
Kushi
Let's see Dr. B. R. Ambedkar
Dr. B. R. Ambedkar Kushi E.P. Tanmay Yes C.P. Tanmay anybody do you have any doubts children How many schedules and articles were there before the time and now articles I want to get the answer from Kushi Navin Hegde
can I see
Navin Hegde
Maji 51 articles
no
Mataji can I say
395 articles and 8 schedules and 22 parts now it is and 98 amendments understood but before that 448 articles were there 2473 amendments was there then 25 parts and 12 schedules was there I think in your textbook they have given a 395 articles and 12 schedules but now not the 12 schedules it is the 8 schedules understood and 98 amendments then 22 parts okay so that is the present document present data of constitution children got it so And another thing is children okay this lesson regarding no doubt
no doubts
no Mataji
okay so I'm getting you are here on the screen I'm getting your attendance but so many children you are not attending only 25 members I can see okay so other children you are not attending the classes why I don't know just I am sharing one some photos regarding your constitution children okay yes can you observe screen al kanustidiya first one it is children
no mataji
before
yes mataji
kanusta ilva during the time
Mataji
everybody please switch off the mic during the time of 1946 to 49 this was the picture constituent assembly picture but now it is parliament children understood constituent assembly hegittu last year avaga matte ivaga hegide ivaga parliament do you know that parliament tv nalli ella torustare alva parliament bagge yes so and these are the pictures of our constituent assembly members children what is that constituent assembly members when the constitution was accepted that day okay the next one is yeah what do you call that preamble what is that emblem alva emblem in front what we can see preamble of the constitution we the people of india having solemnly resolved to anta idiyalva adakke nortteve next yeah this is the first preface of your lesson children sorry your constitution book okay in the constitution book there is a first preface or the first page it will tells the preamble it is in your textbook also children yes Who is the person? Dr. B.R. Ambedkar. In front of the emblem, alva. Can you see?
Yes, Mataji.
Yes, Mataji.
Okay. Here, Constituent Assembly members were there. B.R. Ambedkar and in the right side, Jawaharlal Nehru and Babu Rajendra Prasad. Okay. And Maulana Abdul Kalam in the down left side down corner, Maulana Abdul Kalam, because he was also one of the person or the member of this Constituent Assembly. Is it clear?
Yes, Mataji.
Yes, children. Now, read, go through the lesson, children, first. Then only you can understand. Up to page number 95, you have to read. What is that? Page number, Constitution lesson, page number 93 to 95, you have to read, okay? Next class, we will learn more about the Constitution pictures, okay? So, any doubt? Shall we end the class?
Yes,
okay, Mataji.
Yes,
Mataji. Thank you,
Mataji.
Bye, Mataji.
Mataji, bye.
Bye, Mataji.
Bye, Mataji.
Mataji, bye.
Mataji, bye.
Bye, Mataji.